Hi, my name is Ida Bong. I am a sake specialist for Sake School of America as well as Mutual Trading Company.
はい、こんにちは。私は、エダボンです。酒スペシャリストで、酒スクールオブアメリカと、ミューチュアルトレーディングの社員です。
So today we have a spotlight on Asamai Shizu, and this is a brewery that is located in Akita Prefecture.
はい、今日はですね、浅前酒造、秋田の秋田に、あります浅前酒造を特集します。
So, Akita is known for many things, such as their smoked pickles, vinegar, and rice. And of course, being well known for rice usually goes hand in hand with also being well known for sake.
はい、秋田はですね、有名なものに、いぶりがっこですとか、お酢ですとか、ご飯、ライス、お米があります。で、お酒というのはもちろんお米から作りますから、お酒も大変おいしいということで有名です。
Akita is known as 美酒の王国 or Kingdom of Beautiful Sake. And Akita is actually well known for being one of the top prefectures in Japan in terms of sake consumption per adult.
秋田はですね、美酒王国と言われまして、美味しいお酒で有名なんですけれども、もう一つ有名なのは、県内でのお酒の消費量ですね。
There is actually a little bit of a running joke that Akita was not able to export any sake for a long time because everyone in the prefecture drank all their sake, so there was none left.
はい、はい。ですね、まあ、ちょっと冗談半分によく言われているのは、秋田ではお酒、秋田のお酒というのはなかなか秋田以外では飲めませんというのは、秋田で作られたお酒はほとんど秋田の県内で消費されてしまうからです。
All right. So now that you know a little bit about Akita Prefecture, I'm going to go ahead and introduce who we have here today. So of course we have Toshio Ueno-san, who is the co-founder of Sake School of America, as well as our lead instructor. He is our all things alcohol guru.
はい、それではですね、今日の参加者をご紹介したいと思います。もちろん、上野先生ですね、この Sake School of America の共同創始者でありまして、アルコールに関するグルーと言われるほどアルコールの専門家でございます。
And we're also joined by Asamai Shizu's president, Tsuneki Kakizaki-san.
はい、それで今日ご参加いただけるのは、Asamai Shizu の社長の柿崎常樹様です。
And we're also joined by Akita Trade Promotion Association, Sato-san, so Shiro Sato-san. He's just here to make sure we're doing everything by the books, you know.
はい、それから、今日は秋田県、貿易振興協会の佐藤さんです。
And of course, the lovely person translating for us today is Yumiko Hara-san.
はい、通訳の大原由美子です。よろしくお願いいたします。
All right. So quick overview about the brewery spotlight. We're basically just going to talk about the history of the company, a little bit about the ingredients, so the water and the rice, which are crucial to their kind of philosophy on sake. And then we'll talk a little bit about the brewing process and go into a Q&A.
はい、それでは今日はですね、浅前酒造さんの歴史、それから、重要なお酒の原料であるお米と、お水について、これに関してはとてもこだわられています。それから、お酒のプロセスですとか、そういったことに関してお話しさせていただいて、その後、質疑応答に行きたいと思います。
OK。じゃあ、柿崎社長。お願いします。
どうも、浅前酒造の柿崎です。今日は弊社のこういった紹介ありがとうございます。上野先生、ありがとうございます。佐藤さんもよろしくお願いします。由美子さんも通訳と、よろしくお願いします。弊社はですね、このパワーポイントのスライドを見ていただきたいと思いますけども、大正6年、1917年創業です。
Okay, my name is 柿崎 the president of Amanoto. And thank you for this opportunity to introduce our sake to everybody. Thank you very much. And now I'd like to talk about the history of our company. As you can see on the photo, our company Asamai Shuzo was established in 1917.
はい、じゃあ私の自己紹介ですけれども、まあ、歴史的には100年ちょっとで若いくらいなんですけども、私で5代目、です、私の、経歴としては山形大学の農学部1981年に卒業しました。
Okay, well, our company is 100 years old, which is not too old for a sake brewery in Akita, but I'm the fifth generation of the family who started this brewery. And as you can see, I graduated from Yamagata University Faculty of Agriculture in 1981.
山形大学の農学部では、清酒酵母の研究をしておりました。
My specialty at Yamagata University was the yeast of sake yeast.
その後、大学を卒業したことでは、東京にあります西武百貨店、で、2000年、まま、で西部系のグループで、勤めてまして、百貨店終わった後は新潟と広島で酒造りの勉強をしました。
Okay, after graduating, I worked at a Seibu department store in Tokyo, and then I was training at a brewery in Hiroshima and Niigata, and I was trained in sake making at Niigata and Hiroshima in a group of Seibu department store.
まあ、酒造業界でも百貨店の出身の方が多くて、まあ、14代の高木さんだったり風の森さんの方も百貨店で、勉強されたと聞いております。
Well, there are quite a few people who worked at department store business, and went on to sake making, such as Mr. Takagi at Juyondai, and also Mr. Nagano from Kazenomori as well.
で2000年に浅間酒造の方に、戻りまして、主に製造の方を瓶詰めとか製造の方を中心に働いていました。
And then I came back to Asamai Shuzo in the year of 2000, and I've been working mainly at production of sake, such as bottling.
で、2013年よりですね、私の兄であるの前社長が急逝しましたので、社長を就任して現在に至っております。
In 2013, my brother, who was the president at the time, passed away, and then I took over, and I've been president of this company since then.
アマナトっていうのはアマテラス大御神の、日本の神話で有名なところで、女性の神様で太陽の神様と言われているものから、アマナトと名前を取ったんですけども、古い古化を由来から創業者の方がアマナトという名前をつけました。
Okay, regarding our brand's name Amanoto, the founder of our company named the brand inspired by an old myth or poem based on the Japanese sun goddess called Amaterasu, and she was the supreme god of Japan.
And this is the poem that they are talking about.
そうですね、下に出てきました。天の戸は静かに開けて、上地山、杉の青葉に日陰さす御湯の天の戸という、こう古い古画からあの創業者の方が天の戸と命名しました。そうですね、天の戸はヘブンズドアと言われて、海外の方に出荷されております。
天の戸 means heaven's door.And this is a poem that inspired the founder of our company. As sunlight penetrates the cedar trees leaves on Kamiji Mountain. Kamiji Mountain is the name of the mountain where this myth was based.
そうですね、ヘブンズドアという名前はですね、ノーベル賞をもらったボブ・デュランの中のヘブンズドアという有名な歌が あるんで、それと一緒だったんですごい嬉しいなと思いました。
Okay, actually, Heaven's Door happens to be the name of a song by Bob Dylan, which really pleased me. So, in the overseas market, our Sake is known as Heaven's Door.
それでですけど、うちのラベルの、モチーフとなっているのがこのマガタマで、昔からある天皇家というかある魔除けのものなので、まあ人間の人をですね、あるいは企業だったり、仲間だったりを悪いことから守ってくれるマガタマがうちのモチーフとなってラベルにもあしらっております。
Okay, as you can see, the logo of our sake is called Magatama, and this is the symbol of our company Amanoto.And this stone is used for a necklace in the myth, pictured on our label. And Magatama is supposed to protect you from all evils and protect you from all evil spirits. And it's used as a good luck charm or protection. So we believe that this logo of ours is always protecting us.
秋田の地域です。もう地図で見ていただけますけど、東北地方、日本で言えば日本海側の方にありまして、その中の、天の戸は横手盆地というところがありまして、ちょうど奥羽山脈、真ん中に奥羽山脈が入ってが岩手との境にありますけど、そこに近い、日本一広い盆地の中心というか真ん中にある蔵はあります。
As you can see on this map, Akita Prefecture is located in the northeast part of Honshu, Japan, and our brewery is located in the southern part of Akita, just beside just at the foot of Old Mountain Range, which is between Akita Prefecture and Iwate Prefecture. And this Yokote Basin is considered the biggest basin of all of Japan.
それ雪冬は奥羽山脈があって、そこにぶつかって雪が多くて2メートル、今年も2メートル以上の雪が積もりまして、空気も雪が降ることによってきれいになりますし、酒造り、おいしい水とおいしいお米が取れるので、酒造りには最高の場所です。
We have a large amount of snow because of the location.The Old Mountain Range brings lots of snow to this area, and we had about 2 meters high, the snow of about 2 meters high, and this snow works to make our area really beautiful to look at. And also, this cold climate is very suitable for sake making.
で、これが冬の上から見た蔵の風景です。
Okay, this is a view of our Kura, the brewery building, looking from the higher position.
で、こちらが横手盆地で、大山脈から見たところで、真ん中に見えるのが鳥海山といいまして、東北で一番高い2000メートル以上ある山で、ちょうど秋の風景ですけども、田んぼがいっぱいありまして、黄金色に輝いているかと思います。
Okay, this is a view of Yokote Basin, and looking from the east to the west. And in the middle, you see the mountain. You see a mountain called Mount Chōkai, and you can see the rice fields with golden color in autumn.
こちらは夏の、風景で、空気もきれいで、夕焼けもきれいで、まあ、下が田んぼやぼやけて見えるんですけど、ぜひこの風景もいいんで、見に来てください。
Also, this is the view of the, view of the rice field, in summer.And this is really beautiful. So I would like everybody to come and have a look at this sky and the rice field.
で、こちらはお酒が X がもろみが袋っていうあるんですけども、しずくでポタポタと垂れてるところです。
This is an image of sake filtered through this 袋。The textile to for pressing the moromi, so it symbolizes a drop of this essence of sake.
で、ここのポタポタと落ちてた集めたものが一般にしずく酒と呼ばれております。
So the sake which gathers this all these drops.It's called Shizuku Zake. Shizuku means a drop.
次はうちのお酒は全部純米酒なので、昔ながらの横手盆地で育まれた土地に、よくの。で、稲は育ちます。そして昔から人間が住みやすいとかもしれないんですけど、土器が縄文土器だったり、石器が田んぼの中からたくさん出てきます。
Our sake is born from rice fields in Yokote, Yokote Basin, which is very fertile. And we often discover some of the artifacts from Jomon period, which is a prehistoric period of Japan.
こちらは田植え前のちょうど今の時期、見れる、水鏡というもので、田んぼに水を張った状態で、本当に、鏡のように、空を映したり、雲を映したり、上から見ると本当に綺麗です。
This is a photo of a so-called 水鏡。This is a rice field before planting the rice crops. And it is very beautiful, as you can see, especially when you look at from the higher position. It reflects the sky and it reflects the sky and light, and it's really beautiful.
ここは風吹いてないんですけど、波を立つとすごい綺麗です。波も風が吹くと、まだ綺麗な風の で水面が起きた波も、小さな綺麗な波も見ることができて、それも結構面白いです。
This photo was taken on a day without any wind, but when it's windy, you can see all these waves sparkling, and it's really beautiful as well.
でこちらが田植えを終わったところで、ちょうど今の時期農家の方が忙しく、この作業をしております。
Yeah, this photo is right after the planting of the seedlings, and it is a season now when farmers are busy planting seedlings on the seedlings in the rice paddy.
でこちらがある程度育った時で、まあ、水をある程度抜いて米が成長を良くするのと、美味しくなるようにあの中干しっていう作業のもうちょっと水を引くんですけども中干しという作業になります。
Okay. After that planting of seedlings, the rice plants are growing and maturing nicely.And some water is drained off around this time to help strengthen the plants. And also, it concentrates the flavor of rice with this method of growing rice.
こちらが稲の花で、ちょうど8月ぐらいの上旬に見られるもので、午前中にしか咲かない花で、約4時間ぐらい、午前中に9時から12時ぐらいまで咲いて、残ったものをまた次の日の朝咲くそうです。
Okay, this photo is called 稲の花 or flower of the rice plant, and it only blooms 4 hours a day.And one flower only blooms once. So you can see these flowers from 9 o'clock in the morning to 12 o'clock.
でこちらの白く見えるのは、クモの巣で、この田んぼはあの農薬をほとんど使ってないからこうやってクモが自分生きるために、虫を害虫を捕らえてる風景で朝露に濡れたクモの巣が見れる写真です。
Okay. What you can see these white objects are the spider webs. Because we do not use chemical pesticides, we have spiders as a natural insecticides and It is they are helpful in eradicating all these bad insects.
でこちらは収穫実って9月になってこう稲の方が充実してきてもうそろそろ収穫の時期の稲です。
Okay. Yeah. This photo shows the rice crop nearly ready for harvest in September.
And I believe you guys told me before that since you guys have different rice varieties, they all kind of are ready to be harvested at different times, making it a lot easier for you guys to collect.
酒米の種類なんですけれども、大きな、広い、田んぼをいっぺんにハーベスト収穫するのは難しいので、意図的に違うタイプの酒米をあちこちに植えてそのハーベスト時期をうまくずらすようにしているというふうにお聞きしましたけれどもそうでしょうか、
はい、そうですね、まあ、それも含めて農家の方は長年の経験によって、一番おいしく酒米が収穫できるよう春の種植えの田植えの時期からコントロールしています。
Okay. Yes, you are right. And also, not only the timing of the harvest, but the farmers are researching how to plant each sake specific rice to different locations in order to bring out the best taste, best quality of rice from each location.
Wow, that's a lot of hard work.
あ、それはとても大変なお仕事ですね。
そうですね。やはり、天候に左右されるものなので、天の恵みを受けながら、本当に毎日天候を見ながら、風の刈り取る時期は雨降っちゃうと刈り取りできないんで、本当に刈り取り時期、田植えは雨降ってもできるんですが、稲刈り、刈り取りは雨降ったりするとできないので、その辺のタイミングはすごい長年の関係と勘によって大変なものだと思います。
Yes, it's a hard work and it's based on a long experience of growing rice in different fields. Because rice growing is influenced a lot by the climate, and it is very hard to predict whether predict the weather.During the harvest time. For planting rice, it's okay to have a rain, but for harvesting time, the rain is not very suitable. The farmers have a lot of experience, past experiences, and also intuition when and how to harvest each rice field.
Wow, thank you. That's a lot like how the sake brewers know when to kind of.Go from one stage to the next stage of brewing, huh?
それはまさにお酒を醸造する方々が、プロセスの中で、どういうふう、いつ、は一つのプロセスから次のプロセスに移るかっていうタイミングを測るのと似たようなものですね。カート変遷が必要だということで。
品種によっては米が倒れちゃうので、大変ですね。そのまま特に古い米で背丈の高いものは風や雨によって倒伏しちゃって刈り取るのに大変ですね。はい。
Yeah, that's right. It is very difficult to predict when and how to go about harvesting. Things like old and tall rice plants.Tend to fall down on the ground if we have lots of rain or wind. So it is your long time experience and intuition works a large part in how to go about harvesting.
Oh, wow. Okay. Thank you for sharing that with us. Let's go on to the next slide.
ありがとうございます。面白い、情報ありがとうございます。では次のスライドに行きましょう。
でこれはまあ綺麗な田んぼなんですけど、三山錦でほぼこれから刈り取り時期の田んぼです。
This is a photo of the beautiful rice field with a very ripe 三山錦 and they are ready for harvesting now.
まあ、日本酒の場合は米とさ、ウォーターという水がありますけれども、これはうちに近くにあるビアヌマ幹線という本当に美味しい水がポンポンと湧き出てくるイメージの写真で、水をイメージした写真です。
Okay. In sake making, rice and water are the main ingredients, the very important ingredients.And we talked about rice before, and now this is water that we use for our sake making. This is called Biwanuma Kansen, a very nice, suitable water for our sake making.
これは奥羽山脈の雪解け水とか降った雨が水瀬成瀬の、に流れ込んだものの伏流水としてちょうど盆地の真ん中であります、浅米っていう地区で、湧水が有名な湧水群があって、ここだ琵琶沼幹線だけじゃなくて、周りのところに水が湧いてくるところが何十箇所もあって、湧水の里として、他のところもあるんですが、皆さん人気のスポットになっております。水質的にはpHが中性で、アメリカの高度で48ぐらいの軟水です。
Biwanuma Kansen is a part of the many different water sources. And it is from the melted snow running down from the old mountain range, flowing into the rivers we used to grow our rice. This is a soft water. And according to American measurement, the hardness is 48. So it's a soft water. And this melted snow from the old mountain range flows into two rivers, Naruse and Minase, and it forms an underground aquifer, and it cuts out as a spring in the site of our brewery. So this is a very famous spot for pure, nice spring waters.
And I was wondering, why is it called Biwanuma Kansen?
はい、これがビワヌマ幹線と呼ばれるその理由というか由来は何でしょうか？
沼の形があの楽器のビワに似ているからだと言われております。
Well, it is said that the shape of the pond of this water looks like a biwa. Biwa is a Japanese, Asian, ancient Asian string instrument, which looks like a guitar.So this pond with this water, the shape looks like biwa. That's how the water was named.
All right, thank you so much. Let's move on to the next slide.
はい、ありがとうございます。では次行きましょう。
ここが実際のあのビワヌマ幹線で、浅間酒造天野戸の湧き水を写した写真で2メーターぐらいのところから水がコンコンと湧き出てきてまして、水温は約年間通して13度です。
These are the photos of our well, where the spring water comes out, a lot of, you know, in a large volume. And this is about 2 meters deep. And the average temperature, the temperature throughout the year is around 13 degrees Celsius.
Interesting. And you know, when I first saw this photo up here on the top right, I thought it was plastic covering the well, but it's just very, very clear water.
はい、はい、それはとてもあの興味深い情報ですね。私がこの写真を最初に見たときに、あまりにも透明なので、井戸の上に、プラスチックのカバーをかけているとかと思いました。でも実際はかけてないんですよね。
はい、かけておりませんで、本当にあの無色透明で柔らかくて美味しい水で、町の宝でもあります。
Yes, you're right. This is a very clear, pristine water, and it's delicious to drink, and also very soft. And this is the pride of our town.
この場所はあの100周年の記念事業として、皆さんというか市民あるいはあの県民あるいは観光客に、水を自由に利用してもらおうと思った、水汲み場ですね。はい。
はい。Well, we built this faucet to commemorate our 100-year anniversary.Actually, this is open to public, so anybody can come and have an access to this water. Our neighbors or people from Akita Prefecture or the tourists from outside, anybody can come and enjoy our water.
で、水はすごくきれいで、まあ、アメリカの方でも公社認証ってあると思うんですけども、ユダヤ教の、まあ、あの無印良品みたいなところの種類がどっちもその日本でも、まあ、南部ビキンさんとかボンさんとか獺祭さんが取られてると思うんですけども、うちも公社認証を、まあ、この水がすごいいいということで、ラビンさんっていうのを認定する方が来た時に気に入って、あっという間に公社認証を取ることができました。
あ、すみません、公社認証ってどう書くんですか？
はい、 後者って多分、K-O-C-H-E-R って書いて、スターバックスの、スターバックスの、のあのコーヒーマンにも入ってるんですけども、アメリカではこれはあの大きな市場と聞いておりまして、まあユダヤ教の皇帝に基づいてっていうんですけども、まあどちらかちょっと日本では工業実企画とか、もうそういったもので、多分あのうちも取ったのはあの海外からあのアドバイスでいただいたんですけども、あの海外からあの来た方がこのマークを見ると手に取ってくれるというらしいです。はい。
Okay. So this water we have had we have received the certification by Kosher. Kosher is a Jewish certification system, and it is good for attracting overseas customers. We heard Kosher is famous as such as Kosher is certified for popular places such as Starbucks and in Japan other breweries such as Nambu Bijin and Bon and Dasai they also have a certification as well and it really helps us attracting overseas tourists.
でまあ、あのオーストラリア行った時にも高級スーパーで公社のお肉だとか飲料が売ってるコーナーありましたし、まあ、あの公社の方に聞くとマドンナさんアメリカの歌手の有名なマドンナさんも公社の商品をよく使われているという話を聞きました。
okay. In Australia we heard that Kosher certification is very popular as well and many meat packers and water suppliers, they do have certification. In America, also I heard that Madonna, that famous singer, also likes to have kosher products.
Wow, I had no idea that the water was kosher certified. That's really cool.
水が公社 の認証を取っているとは知りませんでした。とても面白い。
水じゃなくてお酒を取ってるんですけども。
水
水を見てってすごい気に入ってあのうち純米酒だけなんで純米酒というくくりとこの水を自然の水を利用しているということが大きなあのポイントになったと聞きました。
ああそうですか。じゃあ公社すみません公社を取ってるのは水じゃなくてその
お酒です。
失礼しました。Actually, Ida さん、sorry, it's not water which is certified, 公社 certified. It's there. Sake, which is sake, which is has a certification.
That's awesome. You guys need to put that on the website.
それはあのウェブサイトにも書いた方がいいですね。それは素晴らしいですね。
はい。はい、ありがとうございます。ありがとうございます。
Thank you。
まあこちらはあの収穫前の稲の本当にあの綺麗な映像写真です。
Okay, this is a beautiful photo of a rice plant, which is just before the harvest.
まあこの中にまあ米の命が詰まってますね。はい。
So inside this in the photo, the concentrated life of rice, life of rice, the force of rice is concentrated in this photo.
でこれは冬ですけれども、雪が降った玄関の写真と、ふかしが上がっているあの横からの湯気の蒸気の写真と裏から見た写真で雪が降ると空気もきれいになって、仕込みには缶作りとあるように酒造りには最適な環境になります。
This photo shows the winter in this area, and the photo on the right is the front entrance of this brewery. And you can see the when it snows, the air is very clear, and it shows the steam coming out of the brewery because this is season for making sake, and you can see the contrast of contrast of the cold weather and the sake making steams.
あ、こちらは玄米の写真です。これを精米してお酒にします。
This is a brown rice and we are going to polish it to make a sake rice.
まあ、こちらは秋田酒小町の 大吟醸用のお米で、す。うちは平均精米歩合が約 55% でほぼ吟醸作りをしております。
So this is a polished rice, polished down to produce 大吟醸 and our average polishing rate is 55%. ほぼ吟醸作りっておっしゃってました。すいません。あ、すいません、じゃあ 55% が平均で、で、
ほぼ吟醸が多い。大吟醸だと、うちは出品用だと 35-40% まで削ったものを使っております。
For competitions, we use rice polished down to 35-40%.
で、こちらが大吟醸用の、千枚をしているところで、限定給水って言いまして、秒単位、温度を、米の給水を考えながら、限定給水してまして、ざるで研いでおります。
Okay. Well, this is a scene when we are washing the rice, especially for 吟醸sake, and the timing of this washing rice is crucial, so we measure the timing by seconds to produce a premium type of sake, and we are using this plastic sift.
こちらが精米して、限定給水させたものを化して湯気から我が釜っていう釜から、湯気が上がってる蒸気が上がってる写真です。
So we are after washing the rice and the absorption the timing for absorption of water is very very crucial. So we take maximum care in measuring the timing. And after this washing rice, we steam the rice.As you can see in the photo.
で、こちらは麹作りで、の写真で、麹はほぼ手作りで作っております。
So we, the majority of 麹 we make ourselves by hands, no machines used.
でこちらが、酒母といいまして、酵母を純粋培養する、場所で、もろみのほぼ 10% ぐらいの米のを使って、酒母、測定元ですけども、約2週間かけて、酒母を育成します。
This is a photo of a 酒母 or fermentation starter production.So we cultivate we cultivate this shubo, and it takes about two weeks. Majority of our shubo is sokujo, and this is used for 10% of the whole moromi.
まあ、肝とも作っております。
We also Although majority of our shubo is sokujo, we also make kimoto as well.
この写真は仕込みの三段仕込みの中の留め仕込みの ところで、ここで、仕込んだものがもろみの第1日目として数えます。
Okay, this is a photo of the final process of sandan jikomi or three-tiered processing. And this, from this day, we count the day of making sake, for brewing sake.
でこれが、もろみが発酵していまして、アワーリコボを一緒したあのもろみの醸造になります、ちょうど暖かい岩の時期でしょうか、これが上野先生のところでお世話になっている純からというお酒のもろみの醸造というか発酵している途中の写真です。
This is a photo of our fermentation processin this photo, we use the yeast that produces a high volume of bubbles, high volume of bubbles. And this is a very special traditional type of yeast, especially for our product called Junkara, which is also carried by, carried in the United States, available in the United States.And this is a traditional type of yeast.
で、香りはメロンとかバナナのような香りがします。
Mm-hmm. It has aroma of melon. It produces aromas of melon and banana.
で、こちらが、ほぼお酒、もお酒になってでもろみが約20日以上かけて発酵してお酒に絞るタイミングになった時に、この天野ではこの全量袋で絞っております。
So after the fermentation is finished about 20 days after 20 days we go on to this pressing using this equipment
この船は伊藤式船といいまして、約80年前に作られた、まだ現役の本当に貴重な機械です。
Okay. This is a, this, pressing equipment is called 伊藤式船, and it's a type of 船絞り, and this machine was made about 80 years ago.And still in in work, it's still workable.
で、これは瓶詰めの研修しているところで、量が正確に入っているかどうか、異物がないか目視で検査して、お客様に、いいものが届くように検査しているところです。
This photo is about bottling, and this lady is inspecting each bottle very carefully in order to make sure those bottles are good enough. I mean, they pass the inspection standard, so everybody who buys a bottle can enjoy fully.So inspecting is a very important part of our sake making.
これは仕込み水と米が持っている水が一緒ということで、まあ、ラワイの世界ではテロワールという言葉がありますけども、そういったお酒を浅間酒造では、天野戸では醸しております。
In the world of winemaking, they have a word called terroir. And as you can see in this photo, in our sake making, the water, the same water that raises the rice in the summer, brews the sake in the winter. So that means we use only local products. I mean, local rice and water.For growing rice and sake making. So it fits the concept of terroir for winemaking.
これは船から出てきた、船口という場所です。米の色が黄緑、黄色っぽい緑、まさしく米の、色で、とても美味しくて、この場でしか飲めない貴重な、酒で、米と水とそして蔵人の技術の結晶がここに、絞れてきます。
So this is a call. This is a photo called Funaguchi, and the sake just freshly pressed from the pressing comes into this container. And because the sake is very freshly made, the color of the sake is yellowish, and it's a concentration of the concentration of essence of our sake. And you can come here and enjoy this freshly made sake only at this spot.And this is a product of the combined effort between rice, water, and kurabito. So it's a very refreshing drink to have.
で、まあ半径5キロということで、星印のところが蔵がありますけども、オレンジ色のところは5キロないということで、ここら辺で、この辺、エリアの中でお米を作って、もらってます。
Okay. In this photo, the red star is our brewery, and we source our rice from within 5 kilometers from our brewery. So we only used locally grown rice.
あこちらは上野先生のところで、お世話になっているお酒で、純からと表彰という薄濁りです。で、こちらの方は私よりも上野先生の方から、説明していただければと思います。よろしくお願いします。
Okay, this is a photo of two items, which is available in the United States, thanks to Mr. Ueno's company. So rather than me explaining this, these two bottles, I would like Mr. Ueno to talk about it.
Yes, I have tasted this sake just before this show. And Kakizaki Shacho, it's really, really gentle, modest, and very quiet. But however, let's talk about the diamond dust from the right, white one. This is a usunigori type junmai ginjo. As he mentioned, this has a really, really nice, gentle aroma of bananas, pineapple, melons, and then, however,It has a hint of rice he has been talking about. I can smell the steamed rice. I can taste the rice umami. And even though junmai ginjo, this has a, rice, really nice flavors to it. Yet it's not so complex, but it has a substance in it. And I enjoy it so much. And also it has really nice, clean, crisp finish.Also, the other one is on the left. You see a black label with a junkara. This is a junmai style made with Miyamanishiki and Ginosei branded. And it's a, junmai style. So it has more of steamed rice and lactic notes to it. And also it has a really, really rounded, soft mouth feel.In front palate, but however, from mid to finish, it has more layered flavor comes out, umami comes out, rice flavor comes out, and some of the fruits character like zesty orange, and some pineapple again with banana. But main component in here is that mouth feel is so gentle, and the flavor comes out slowly in develops in your mouth and finishes. I think this one is, as it says, it's jun means rich and kara means dry. So the finish is very nicely dry and yet the soft mouthfeel stays in your mouth. So it's very, very well balanced. And I enjoyed it. I want to eat this. I want to drink this with next time I visit Akita with some of the local food, chicken, some of the beef, and also a kiritampo. Kiritampo made with rice is their local cuisine. So I want to try and I want to go there sometime in the future. And I think you guys should visit them. I heard after the summer, around September, it's going to get a little bit chillier. Summertime get hot, but wintertime is, you know, you saw the picture, so it's very, very snowy, but it's very nice. And if you're not drink those Funaguchi sake just pressed, I think you should go there with wintertime to have, even he might have some daiginjo, ginjo, shiboritate with a fukurotsuri. I know he does fukurotsuri too. So you can enjoy those in maybe in February and March. And then you can go to nearby onsen. He said that there is a few onsen places in town. So you stay in a ryokan, go to onsen. Go to Amanoto and visit and drink some Amanoto sake and go back to ryokan and eat good food and get into the onsen. That's the plan, I think.
Thank you so much. We're running just a few minutes over, but we're almost at the end here.
はい、ちょっと時間がかかってしまいましたけれども、そろそろ終わりです。はい。あ、社長どうぞ。
あ、どうも、心ほんのり純米酒ということで、ちょっとここの写真は、袋ずりをしてた頃の写真で、飛びんどりしているところの写真です。本当に、心ほんのり、天野津純米酒を楽しんでいただければ幸いです。ありがとうございます。
Okay, so you, this photo is a photo when a 袋ずり method of pressing is extracting sake. So our catchphrase is Junmai that warms the heart, Amanoto. So I would like everybody to enjoy this sake. Thank you very much.
まあ、冬の景色です。
So this is a scenery of our winter. So it really shows nicely water and rice.
You know, I thought that was a Mount Fuji, but it's not.
あ、ちょっとこれ富士山かと思ったんですけど違ったんですね。
鳥海山です。鳥海山の、秋田富士と言われてまして、本当に富士山のように均等に見えますけれども、山形方面から見るとちょっと違う、形に見てます見えます。はい、2200メートルぐらいある高さの山で、鳥海鳥の海と書く山です。
Okay, this is this looks very much like Fuji, Mount Fuji, but this is called Chōkai-san. Chōkai-san means a bird and sea, and this looks very much like Fuji-san because it's symmetric. But from the other side, from Yamagata Prefecture, it looks a little bit different in shapes, and it's about 2,000 meters high.
That's what we said about Mount Fuji in Yamanashi and Nagano. We said it always, Yamanashi people say, Mount Fuji looks better from the Yamanashi side, not from Shizuoka side.
はい、まあ、富士山も同じように、静岡サイドと山梨サイドの人たちはこちらの方がうまくきれいに見えるんだよと言ってますね。By the way, this is called Akita Fuji. Its different name is Akita Fuji because it looks like a Mount Fuji.Based in located in Akita.
まあ、これは 諸見うちは開放タンクではこのように使ってまして、2つホースが見えますけども、これは冷温器でやって、もろみを美味しくするために温度を冷やしている操作です。
This is a photo of the moromi, and we are using this 冷温器 to cool down the fermentation process.
Thank you. ありがとうございました。長い間天野との写真見ていただきてありがとうございました。アメリカの方にも言ってますよ、上野先生のところの順から、表彰よろしくお願いいたします。
Well, thank you very much for listening and watching these photos of our brewery. I hope this helps Mr. Ueno and his business in promoting our sake to American market. Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you. We have a couple questions. Do you mind if we stay on for a couple more minutes?
はい。じゃあですね、質問をいただいてるんですけれども、もう少しお時間いただいてもよろしいでしょうか、柿崎社長。
はい、大丈夫です。はい。
It's okay.
All right. Thank you so much. The people wanted to know what are the six rice varieties that the brewery uses, and are they all grown within 5 kilometers of the brewery?
はい、ですね、まず最初の質問なんですけれども、今使われている酒米6種類全部名前を教えていただけますでしょうか、それからそれが全部5キロメートル以内の田んぼから来るものでしょうか。
はい、今年はそうです。はい、秋田酒小町、銀の瀬、宮間錦、星明かり、亀の王、それとあとは三郷錦を言いました。銀の瀬、宮間錦、星明かり、亀の銀の瀬、秋田酒小町です。はい。
はい。Okay. So those six varieties are 秋田酒小町、はい、銀の瀬、
はい、
宮間錦、星明かり、はい、亀の王。はい。The last one is 三郷錦。
はい、で表彰は星明かりを使っております。
Okay. 表彰 is mainly using 星明かり。表彰 or diamond dust, actually. Diamond dust is using 星明かり。
And yes, and are they all grown within 5 kilometers?
That's right. それはみんな 5km 以内に作られたものでしょうか。
はい、そうです。
Yes, up to now, yes, it is.
Okay, and what kind of yeast do you use for brewing sake?
はい、使われてる酵母は何でしょうか？
何種類か使ってまして、9号系で秋田流花酵母という、と自社酵母が2種類、それと協会の10号。というものがメインに使ってまして、あとは一部秋田小野さんというところから、ナンバー29、ナンバー12、使ってまして、順からの方は秋田小野さんのナンバー29です。で、表彰は秋田小野さんのナンバー12を使っております。
Okay. We have variety of yeast to be used for different types of sake. For example, we have number 9, number 9, and Akita Hana, we use number 9 and also 21 called Akita, and we have two kinds of homegrown, home cultivated yeast, and also we have Kyokai number 15, and also we have special kobos grown
original yeast
called 29 and 12, developed by Akita, developed by a producer called Akita Kono.
Yes.
And for Jun color, we use 29, and we for diamond dust, we use 12, number 12. So we have, you know, many different kinds of kobo for yeast for different purposes.
Thank you, Shacho, for みんな教えていただきましてありがとうございます. Thank you.
Yes, it's very interesting to kind of start dissecting sake and learning about like what they use and how that changes the end product.
いろいろね、違う製品に違う酵母を使われるというのは非常に面白い、興味深い情報でした。ありがとうございます。
And just to make it clear, somebody was asking about the Toji Guild you guys are in. You're in the Sannai Toji Guild, correct?
どこの当時に属してらっしゃるのかという質問がありましたけれども、 Sannai Toji でよろしいですね。
秋田県にあります。 Sannai Toji です。
Yes, that's correct. Sannai Toji in Akita Prefecture.
And can you tell us what makes Sannai Toji Guild kind of unique?
Sannai Toji の特徴といえば どんなものがございますか？
秋田缶作りで、 割と豆の豆を出してくれる当時で、いろんな技術持ってるんですけども、ちょうど来年今年ですか、100周年迎える当時組合です。で、いろんな県っていうか、県外にも昔は山内地方から酒造りに広島だったり、灘だったり、関東地方面だったり、出て山内当時の技術を持った日本酒が広まって、多分いろんな作り方含めて山内日本酒っていうのは丹波当時だったり、いろんなところの技術が組み合わさりながら複雑に融合しながら日本酒っていうのはできてるんではないかなと個人的には思います。
You know, one of the best way to learn this, especially Sannai Toji and Akita, is you know, we offer Japanese Sommelier Association's sake diploma. You're going to be studying a lot. A couple of pages are designated for Akita, and they talk about Sannai Toji and all the rice varieties. And so I recommend you guys to challenge those very difficult exam, but. If you are interested in, we're going to start studying from this fall, and the new book is already here. If you want to purchase them, let us know.
今の山内講師に関して翻訳します。通訳しますか? よろしいですか?
Oh, I'm sorry. Could you translate what Kakizaki-san said before? About the 100, their yes. anniversary and everything.
okay. Yeah, just to summarize what he said, it's celebrating its 100 year anniversary, Sannai Toji. So it's a very, you know, it has a long history of making sake, and they have, variety of techniques to make good sake. Especially in Akita, we have a method called Akita Kanzukuri. So Kanzukuri is, brewing sake in the cold temperature, and it concentrates umami of rice, and also we have a history of going out to different parts of Japan, including Hiroshima and Kanto area and other places to spread our. Technique, as well as learning their technique to bring back to Akita. So I believe personally that all these techniques has been learned and exchanged throughout the history in all over Japan.
Awesome, thank you so much. This is going to be our last question. So the pressing system that they have with the smaller bags, it seems very labor intensive, and maybe it's not very efficient, but is there a reason why they choose to do that pressing style?
You mean the fukuro zuri? You mean the fukuro zuri? Yeah, okay.
Yes.
Sorry.
The bags are very small, that's why.
Mm-hmm. Okay, yeah. Right. はい、先ほど絞りの、シーンで拝見したんですけれども、とても小さなバッグを使う袋を使って、はい、絞ってらっしゃいますね、船絞り、あれはとてもたくさんの手間がかかりそうなんですけれども、なぜあれを採用されるんですか？船絞りですね。
船絞りは袋自体がきれいな六角装置になってまして、最初行った時に船が入った時に外側に米の層ができるので、やっぱり圧を少しずつかけてきれいに絞るためには、大きい袋だと、多分破けたりすると大変なので、小さく小分けしながら、包み重ねていって、袋取り滴も小さい袋取りのそれの応用編っていうか、きれいに、この袋の一個一個の中に、米の、酒粕っていう、後から出てくる酒粕なんですけども、そこに層を作っていって、そこで、酒で酒を絞るっていうか、きれいにしていく、味わい深くしていくっていう操作が、多分、経験上これぐらいの袋が一番適していたんではないかなと思います。
Okay, from our long history of experiences, these small bags are proven to produce the best quality of sake because they have a very finely woven texture, textile is used, and it, presses and filters the sake very cleanly and nicely, and separate the liquid from nicely separate the liquid from the solid parts, as sake kasu. And I believe this size has been proven to be the most efficient and best to produce good quality sake.
あとは人間の作業上、あれぐらいが一番作業しやすい、と思います。いい質問ありがとうございました。もうちょっと勉強してみて、その袋の大きさとか、もうちょっと勉強してみたいと思います。ありがとうございました。
Thank you for asking that question. I'd like to learn more about the size of the 袋 or bag, but thank you for the good question.
All right, thank you so much. So I that was going to be the last question, and I'm going to just go ahead and put this in the chat, but that's going to be Amanoto and Asamai Shizuo's website and Facebook. If you actually go to their Facebook and look for their videos, they have a ton of videos where they're kind of showing what they do in the brewery a lot of the time. So you'll see a lot of cool stuff.
ではこれで質問終わりたいと思います。Amanoto のウェブサイトですとか、Facebook に行くと、いろいろな動画とか写真がありますので、その袋絞りの様子もわかると思います。
And we're just going to go ahead and close it up with some final remarks. Does Kakizaki-san want to say anything?
最後に、Kakizaki 社長から、一言、お言葉をいただきたいと思います。お願いいたします。
皆さん、今日はどうも見ていただいてありがとうございます。日本酒、本当に、美味しいもの、今年もできておりますので、コロナが明けたら日本に遊びに来て、酒蔵を訪問していただければと思います。まずはこういう状況なので、日本酒、お料理と一緒に楽しんでいただいて、ければ、幸いかなと思います。まずは発酵は体にいいので、ほどほど飲んで、皆さんで一緒に、頑張っていきましょう。先生から何か一言、上野先生からお願いしたいなと思って、私よりも、そういったもっと楽しみ方っていうのは、多分海外の方の日本酒の楽しみ方っていうのはもうちょっと違うものありますので、その辺も含めてぜひ先生お願いします。
Okay, well, thank you very much for watching our webinar. And sake is very, very delicious, as you see. And I hope after this corona, I hope this COVID-19 is over, I would like everybody to come over and visit our brewery. And in the meantime, please enjoy our sake with pairing with food. And because fermentation products, food and drink are very good for our health, I hope our sake will keep you keep your enjoyment and health. And please enjoy our sake in moderation, of course. And I would like Mr. Ueno to have a word as well, please. Thank you.
Thank you, Kakizaki Shacho, so much for your time and the presentation that you prepared for us. And Hala-san, also thank you. And mostly, I'd like to thank you to the all the attendees today again and then again. Many of you are a repeater of this webinar. We really appreciate your coming back and listen to us and watching these sake breweries and supporting us. I really appreciate that. And as Kakizaki-san, as Shacho said, especially Amanoto sake should be tasted with food. But I think I need to promote how to pair with the food in here in like local cuisine. And but first things that you can do is try something like oysters and cheese, like blue cheese, manchego cheese, Gruyere cheese. Those cheese. The reason why is it's simple, you know. Those shellfish, I've been saying this so many times, those oysters and crab meats and lobsters and shrimp has a succinic acid. And the sake has a large component of succinic acid too. And white cheese, because sake also has a large percentage components of the lactic acid in there. And the cheese has a lot of cheese and fermentation food has, you know, a lactic acid. And you know, a little bit of a saltier side of the cheese goes well with sake. So remember, blue cheese and dry currants or dry fruits, and drink this will be so good. So and also the another thing you should know about this kind of sake, especially junkara, you know, when you are pairing with the soup. Like hot meal, it's really tough to pair with, you know, wine, but you can warm, especially this junkara, you can warm this sake up and taste with like soup dish and warm food. That'll be so fantastic. And also grilled meats and grilled fish. So, and I think I saw so many people in the chat saying they want to go to Akita. So Sato-san, many people want to go Akita and visit Asamai Shizo and drink Amanoto and visit onsen and eat local foods too. But until then, we enjoy our, you know, American food with Amanoto sake.
Eda-san, Sato-san, Yumiko-san, arigato, sensei, arigato.
Arigato gozaimashita.
Arigato gozaimasu. Okay, thank you guys so much. Again, big thank you to Asamai Shizo and also the Akita Trade Promotion Association, Sato-san there. And we'll see you guys next week.